One night, while the Buddha was residing at Uruvela Kassapa's temple, Uruvela Kassapa and his Brahmins observed many bright lights shining from inside the worship hall. Uruvela Kassapa entered and asked,
"Sir, we are all seeing great lights shining from the worship hall. This has never happened before. Please tell us, what is going on?"
"Listen closely, and I shall explain the source of the lights. The first set of lights came from the Catu-Maharaja, the four heavenly kings. They came to hear a Dhamma sermon." Uruvela Kassapa then thought,
"Wow, this monk is truly great. In all my years, I've never been visited by the four heavenly kings. However, he is still not an arahant like I am."
On the following night, Uruvela Kassapa and the Brahmins observed a greater set of bright lights coming from the worship hall. Uruvela Kassapa asked the Buddha,
"Sir, for a second night, we saw bright lights shining from the worship hall. Please tell us what is causing them."
"The second set of lights you saw came from Saka, the Lord of Heaven, when he came to hear me teach the Dhamma." He then thought,
"Wow, this monk is truly great. In all my years, I have never been visited by the four heavenly kings, let alone Saka, the Lord of Heaven. However, he is still not an arahant like I am."
On the following night, Uruvela Kassapa and the Brahmins observed an even greater set of bright lights shining from the worship hall. Uruvela Kassapa asked the Buddha,
"Sir, for a third night, we saw an even brighter set of lights coming from the worship hall. Please tell us what is causing them."
"The last bright light you saw was from when Brahma, the great god, came to listen to the Dhamma." Uruvela Kassapa was in shock. In his entire life of dedicated practice, he had never been visited by any of these great beings. He thought,
"How great must this monk be if these great beings came to worship at his feet? But still, this monk is not an arahant like I am."
This made Uruvela Kassapa begin to worry. He thought,
"Tomorrow, many disciples are coming to make a great offering. If this monk shows his immense powers, all my gifts will be given to him and not to me. How can I stop him from appearing at tomorrow's event?"
That night, the Buddha was able to read Uruvela Kassapa's thoughts. The following day, the Buddha went for alms alone in a different region from the day before. The next day, Uruvela Kassapa came to visit the Buddha and asked,
"Sir, yesterday we prepared food for you, but you did not come."
The Buddha then said, "Uruvela Kassapa, I read your mind and knew of your worries. For this reason, I went for alms at Uttara Kurdawipa." Uruvela Kassapa thought,
"How powerful is this monk? He can even read my mind, but he is still not an arahant like I am."
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.